Really, you got these nice vents, and I says, I hope I've not marked it already. You got these nice vents, and when I look on the bottom of this one, you got these nice vents, but then you got these silly stickers. And these vents, you need these vents to be kept clear, because it does get really warm in there sometimes, especially on a warm day flying around and you've got more than a couple of batteries. But look, a third of my ventilation's covered up. And I stick my finger in the butt of it to check for heat, and sometimes it can get really warm in there. And like I say, you know, after a couple of batteries and on a warm day. And I wonder if, you know, just having that bit of extra ventilation could help. So I'm certainly not going to put stickers across here at all. I've put this back together, and I've put some of this nice, I got the white stuff last time and it's pretty good, I'm quite impressed with it, but this stuff's clear. It's an extra 50p, but it's clear. I'm going to see what this is like. But I've put some across the top of there, you can hardly see it, can you? Which is great. So, and then I thought, well, what I could do is I could just set that in, get it sort of glued, and then it'll be ready for tomorrow for me to build it up again. But of course, I've got to wait for that, because that takes quite a while to go off. So I found something a little bit noteworthy here. Now, I put the board back in for the camera, and it was just proving to be a little bit of a pickle. I'm trying to figure out exactly how to put the antenna in. And the reason why I say that is because even with that, is it called a planar antenna? The square antenna that I've got? It doesn't matter how close I am. If this is turned a certain way, I lose signal. It doesn't matter what channel I put it on, I lose signal. And I'm sure I've mentioned this either in a video that I have put up or haven't put up, that I'm going to actually, for close range, I'm going to put the internal antenna that came with it back in and see if that fares any better. But the little antenna, the transmitter antenna, it did come round and it came over down this leg here, and the wire seems excessively long, but it came down this leg here, or this, and because I couldn't quite work out where to put it, and because it doesn't work as well as what I would hope, you know, like I say, when it turns, I've just stuck it down the front here. Now, chances are I'm going to have to go into this again at some stage anyway, either to, you know, swap back out or into the black. But there's something as well here, is there are, on two of these motors, if I remember rightly, if I position this here, on two of these motors, it has these washers. Now, they're pretty rusty, the washers, and I've been looking for a spare set of screws. Not that I need them, I've got all the screws, it's just I wondered if they had these washers in there, and they don't have them in the spare sets of the screws, the fixings for this. And I'm wondering why there is actually just two, and they're on the opposite legs as well. There's another washer there, and the washer's down here for this, and that goes there, not opposite each other, on the same side, but on the two opposites, nothing. As you can see, there's not been any sort of washers here, and this one, and also that's the same for this side, no washers. I'm just wondering why they're there. Is there a slight imbalance in the actual shell, and they found that putting the washers there would help with vibration or something, ease vibration if it's slightly off? I don't know, honestly don't know. But I tell you this, is I did notice that when I used to put this on top of this desk, it did have a slight wobble. Not on one side, but on the other side, it was like there was a millimeter or something gap where there was a slight bit of movement, so you could tilt it. Just an observation. The worth noting that putting this back together, of course, I'm going to have to put the washers back onto the same places. I have asked about this at Hubsan, but sometimes it can take quite a few days to get a reply. I'm sure they're very busy there, dealing with all sorts of things. But I'm going to put them back in, just because they were there anyway. I just thought that was noteworthy. Setting in the camera, I've screwed this down, so I'm not going to take it all apart again. I just want to get it back together again now, really. Get off my bench. I've got other things I want to be able to do. I keep getting notification about this this RD power supply that I bought. The DPS 5015. About, you know, if I've got any problems with it, I've got to notify them really quickly because the warranty, well, runs out. How long have I had it? Not very long. Couple of few weeks, but the warranty is about to run out on it, so that's of course I have to keep checking this camera as well to make sure that's working. So I need to do some stuff with that. I did ask actually the RD Tech, whatever it's called, if it would be okay using inductive loads like my solid state Tesla coil, but he hasn't got back to me at all with that. I don't know if he's I'm going to respond because I've asked him to take off the adverts off my videos, because he's put adverts on a few of my videos and I'm not particularly happy with that. And don't get me wrong, you know, it's okay, I put a link in the description, but I don't really want adverts on my videos. So, I digress. I'm going to put these back in. I'm going to leave that little antenna down, just down the front there, sort of loose. I don't think it's going to matter too much. I mean, here, I'm trying to fit it in down, back down here again. It's a bit of a pain in the butt, to be fair. So we'll just see how that goes. I can always, you know, take it out and just take this off and move it out again. It's not going to be such a big problem, really. It's a whole bunch of screws, yeah. And earlier on, when I looked at these screws, I thought, oh, wow, there's just quite a lot, so I bagged them in order to work out what to put where again. I decided, because I didn't know about putting the board down, which exact screws they were, I went through process elimination. I know they're for the motors, I know they're for the main shell, and those little ones there are for the top pieces, GPS and the compass, and these other thin ones are, you know, I actually forgot what they are, but these are the ones here for the board. So as I get through them, I'll be running out of screws, and then when there's holes, I'll just put in what's left. Oh, I know where those thin ones are for. They're for the you know, for the feet. Not here, for the feet. Underneath, you know, there. But anyway, we'll get around to that in a little bit. So I wonder if I should carry on filming this, putting it back together again, because it is taking a bit more time. It's a lot easier to take it apart, because it's just a case of taking the screws out, taking it apart, but trying to put it back together again. Get everything nice is a bit more time consuming. I can't really see. Is the guy being really that interested in watching that? So, there's my tweezers, flat ends, look, no pointy bits. save me from digging it into my fingers, but obviously I'm a bit unsafe with tweezers. That should just snugly fit in there nicely, I'm hoping. That's it, yeah, beautiful, that'll do. It's quite a nice little snug fit. Gotta get it right, gotta have it nice. So there's one in, nice and snug, everything out of the way. Of course, I've still got the LEDs to put through, and I'm probably will have to pull these out again, so I don't even know why I'm bothering to put those in. I should probably be just getting these clamped down and then just working from there, so I'm going to do that. This has got two screws in it, here and here, not at the back just yet, just in case I had to take it apart. So I wasn't quite sure where this goes, but does that go in there? It doesn't look like it, does it? Where does that go? No, that doesn't go there. Well, that wire is quite short. Does it go across the top? No. And there's nothing underneath the board. And this has got one, two, it's got a whole bunch of connections there. This one's only got four. Oh, here we go. It probably goes over here, so I'm probably going to pull that away from there, push it underneath here, and it will go into this top part here. Beautiful, okay, that's good. Is the camera still working? Yep. It's got to get warmed up a bit first, and it seems to be once it gets too warm. It was all happening a lot quicker when it was on 60 frames a second. But I just leave it on 30 frames now. Looking good, man. It's looking good, and it doesn't seem to be any movement either on it where these pressed down. There doesn't seem to be a clink, 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 clink type that there was with the black case. That's pretty firm. Each corner, I can't tap down and there be any movement. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. I was debating whether to put the 5.8 gig transmitter aerial antenna, that's what it was supposed to go. There's those little grooves that you can put the wires through. Like that. Okay, that should fit in place quite nicely. That's good, it looks like it's all in the right place. Two grooves, one side you can fit the LED lights down, and the other side you can fit the motor wires down. Hoping that's all in the right sort of space for it. Okay, I wonder why this is here, whether I should try fitting that. I'm pretty sure that just sits in here. It says a bit fiddly. I'm pretty sure it just slides in. That's it. That's slid in, but I think, I don't know. It's all got lots of gunk, so you can't be touching anything. But that is slid into that space now, and it's not going to be. Well, the body should be coming together. Hopefully that won't block anything or be in the way. Right, so that's that side. That side. And the USB's in. It's just these two now. Right, we're in there, good to go. So I'm going to put the top together now. Oh, it's getting there, isn't it? Right, so I've got this glass bit, this canopy even, and of course the wider parts at the bottom, so that's pretty much self-evident how that's going to go together. If I put the... self-evident, I'm trying to put it in from the wrong way around. There we go, and then just push the top bit, that just clips into place, nice. And then the nose part, it's going to go something like that, and just clip in, does it? Is it going to snap into place? Well, it's definitely in place, it's just not made any real clicky noises, but that's, well, that's the top bit. I don't think they need any sort of gunk or gum on them or anything. It does look pretty cute in white, actually. But then I saw quite a lot of videos, they all had white ones, and I really like the look of the black one. Right, so GPS and compass. If I can just move this up a little tiny bit. Let's do the compass first. Compass nice and easy, two screws, and it just goes there. Now, I tried doing this without putting the compass in screwed into place correctly. When I first took this thing apart, and it doesn't want to start up. It won't fly unless you put it in the right way around. So there's a little. A little something that's not working. So I'm thinking I'm just trying to do this all around, so that's it. So then it wants to go this way as well. So the screws go in like that and it sits just underneath the canopy. Like this rather than like that. Yep. I want those little tiny screws for this, don't I? Let's get one. Put the first one in, just get it in place. But yeah, it's quite sensitive, this is to how it wants to be. That camera's still working. Yep. Surprise, surprise. I'll pick up the little screws with this. Maybe there's a thing that they don't want to be magnetised at all. I assume that's probably correct. Get in the hole. And level so it sits firm. Now that's something I've noticed about this compass this time. I'm sure I've already said this, but I could have said it in the bit of the film that I lost. The screwdriver doesn't fit them little tiny screws, does it? No. Yeah, is that it takes a lot longer now to calibrate the compass. It used to be two turns clockwise and then two turns anti-clockwise, but now it's more like four or five turns clockwise. That doesn't seem to be fitting in as well as I hoped. Maybe it's just down to me not applying enough pressure. Let's just see if I can just. Oh, okay, that's better. A bit better. Better. That's a lot. Yeah, that's better. It's because I was pushing on the shell a little bit and I was trying to be dead careful about pushing on the shell, but that's certainly fit into there. Okay, and now we've just got this. Now this side is the part that faces upwards, and if I remember correctly, this bit goes up the back. That just fits in like that. Just trying to get it over the holes. It doesn't fit nicely into place like the main board does, where you've got a couple of holes to line it up with, but never mind. Let's just get one of these in each corner. Oh, opposite corners. And then it's got the it's got a lining to go, goes that way, to go between this actual fact. It's going to go whichever way this wire goes through. I actually cut this in here to make it easier to get onto here, otherwise it was, yeah, this sits down. It doesn't, I push this up nice and firm into the top, rather than have it the way it was, because it's supposed to be a screen between those two things. Have it around it and as far away from the rest of it as possible. But very sensitive to GPS, on the point of you put your hand over, and this is normal as well. I've asked not Hubsan, if you just put your hand over the top, you lose all GPS. And if it turns over, if it, you know, if it spins over, you lose GPS as well. But I don't use the GPS so much now. I mean, I don't use the GPS, so I might take it up. Screw them. Might take it up first of all, you know, and just let it hover there for a second. Or if there's people about, show off a little bit and let the GPS hold it up and then just walk away from it without even looking at it. Showing off there. Come in, you little monkey. This is probably the fiddliest bit, is trying to get these bloody screws in, because they're not magnetic, or they don't seem to be, they won't be picked up on my screwdriver. Ah, damn. Let's try. Just put it on the end. Put the light down on my lens so I can see. Oh, see, that just falls straight off. Okay, right, so that's the front, and so then wires are going to come down in this side, so I want to put my this in here, like this, putting those wires through the gap, so I can just push all this up nice and snug into the top of this. Hoping that any interference is going to stay out of this area. Just let it get on and do its job. Across the road from me, where there's a field, unfortunately, there's a transmission bloody mask. And I forgot, I used to go and see a friend up there, and her place was right by the transmission mast, and I actually forgot it was there. I don't know if that had been causing me to a few little issues, so that's that. I'm just going to connect these into these, pop that on there, put the thinner screws through the base of this into this, and then lock these screws into there, and we are pretty much put together. But I really need to go for, oh, and I'm going to hot glue that. I've had the heater on the hot glue now, so that should be nice and warmed up. On the gun, I should say. Hot glue gun, so I'm just going to push that. Because I've got to make sure that there's, that the battery can get in and out. So just give me a tick. I'm going to go and find a battery to put in it, and make sure that's out of the way. Knocked all this out of the way again. What's going on there? There we go. Right, so I've got a battery. I've got a cup of tea. Relieved myself. Okay, right. Battery. Nice. It's good so far. That aerial doesn't actually get in the way of that in the in the right sort of place, which is good. Just pull it back out again. I'm just going to chuck a bit of hot glue down now. Pretty sure it's going to be okay where it is, but I'm just going to chuck a little bit down there to just ensure. If I just move that wire out of the way there, so I can get the nozzle of my glue gun in. I'll show you. I just turned the bloody thing up when I was doing that. So there's just a little tiny gap down there. I'm just going to chuck a little bit of glue just in there, just so it just doesn't vibrate out at any stage, so it becomes a problem putting the battery in and out. I'm not sure if you can actually see that, and I'm really sorry if you can't, but it's I'm going to a slightly different angle because I'm governed by having to put in the USB cable to charge it. And at the same time, I didn't realise the camera had gone off. I just checked it to make sure it was still working and it was all off. But never mind. It's all in nice, and there's no, on the black one, it was almost like it was just slightly off, so you'd have a bit of movement, clip, 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 but this, there isn't any. The motors look like they're nicely in those, beautiful. Okay, well. I'm going to put the back door on, even though I've got a white one coming. But I'm going to put the back door on anyway, because I was going to think about that, because the batteries are so slow. What do I do with that battery? Pop it underneath there. No, it's right in front of the eyes. Because the batteries are so snug, it's not going to fall out, especially the way I fly. I could quite happily fly it like that. So I'm just, I'm just gentle and smooth and quicker. I'd say twice as quick, maybe even. Three times quicker than the GPS, but not, you know, full blasted mode. I've had a succession of motorbikes in my time, and most of them, well, the last three were Kawasaki Ninjas 750s. I absolutely love the 750s. Just got plenty of power, absolutely plenty of power. But it's the one thing I look at is you don't just because you've got all that. With mine, with the stage 3 tuning and everything, it was like 175 mile an hour jobby. But it doesn't mean to say you've got to open that up everywhere you go, you know, you can just gently have it and have nice power and smooth. And that's the way I look at these, especially since a couple of crashes. So, I think I might just power it without, I've got no charge actually. Oh yeah, I've got 7 volts on those batteries, haven't I? So I have got, and it's showing up red now on the battery indicator on the handset. and in total then that gave me 10.5 flights on a single charge from full power 8.4 down to 7 volts. 10.5 cycles. Hey, that's good. That's good. I don't care who you are, that's good. There we go. There we go, there we go, there we go. Right, I'm going to drink my cup of tea now. I'm going to say goodbye 5 minutes and drink my cup of tea and come back when I have had a biscuit. Well, I sort of, I don't want to say lied, I misspoke. I'm too excited. I've drunk half my tea. I've not had a biscuit yet. But I'm gonna chuck on the props that I've been using while it was black. As you can see, not really damaged. But I was out over my mate's field and plenty of spares. I've got a load of black ones as well. And I took it really quickly into a turn, going really fast forward in altitude hold mode, because this thing, I don't know how to shift when it wants to, more when you make it. And I think it snapped a prop. There's one. What's that? It's a B. And that's got to be an A then. Okay. Right, so let me just get, well, before I power up that transmitter, not so bothered about putting that on so much. We don't want to run it without this on, because I'm not sure, but if it's anything to do with like CB radios, if you don't have your aerial on so it's tuned, you can have very nasty VSWR ratio, or VSW ratio, the voltage standing wave ratio, and that's not healthy for your transmitter. That's all. I am literally going to start this puppy up here. First of all, we're going to, I hope you can see that. So we're in the red on the battery on there. So I'll just tilt that up a little bit. We're in the red on the battery. Well, we'll be alright because it's got 7 volts, and as long as those batteries don't get below 6.8 type thing for my comfort. So, of course, we want the all important video to kick in. Please don't go puff. Watch, bang, that's a good sign. That's a good sign. And we've got video, the all important video. Gyro sensor's happy, it's calling for me to calibrate compass 1. This might take a bit of a time because it's been being like that. So this is when it'd be normally done by now with the old control board that I had. Still asking me to calibrate compass 1. Okay, still asking me to calibrate now compass 2. As you can see, the lights changed as well. This one's normally done a lot quicker. About 2 on this one, that'll be done as it used to be. This is halfway into the second one. That's the second turn. Halfway into the third. Third turn, we're done. Okay, I suppose the next part is to arm it. We got no power on the battery at all on both items. I got 6 GPS on the handset. Nothing on the quads, but that's alright. I can tell it to start up without needing GPS because this is the new board. So I'm just going to tell it to fly when there's no GPS. I'm ready to start it because I don't intend on taking it off anywhere. It's not going to go anywhere. I'm just gonna get it to go. It's in altitude hold mode anyway. I've got nothing that's gonna go nuts, have I? And so you can see that. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And that was just the test. So we're all good? We are all good. I'm going to charge that up. I'm going to stick myself some batteries on charge. And have I got two charged? I have. I was charging two the other day. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I forgot about those. So actually all I can do is I can do a quick blast charge with my Sky RC into these. That gives me about an hour to get something to eat. And then I can rush off down to the field and see how quick I can lose my quad. Joking, just give it a natural fact. While I put those on charge, I might as well stick another couple in parallel and charge on that thing and have four batteries. Doesn't seem to be particularly windy out there at all. So that's it, guys. That seems to be a bit of a mission complete. I haven't put the back door on yet, but I may not. Probably will. But it works. It works, everything calibrates in, everything does as it's supposed to, it starts up as it's supposed to, and there's all the telemetry's there, everything's as it should be. So there you go, that's the shell swap out. Hope you enjoyed the video, hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed actually making it. It's been quite good, it's just nice that it works. Oh, little droney. And he's got a brand new suit. Brilliant. Till next time, take it easy, and I shall see you soon. Thanks for watching.